All right, and we're back for day four. Great to see you again. So a lot of people talk about liver detoxification and detoxing, but did you know that the state of your liver health has a direct impact on the state of your gut health, or that it can cause a leaky gut? Believe it or not, but when you have an autoimmune disease like Hashimoto's, the liver is often a big, big player. The functionality and the activity of the liver slows down because thyroid hormone output is lower than normal. You need adequate thyroid hormone levels to keep the liver working optimally. Now, even if you are on thyroid replacement medications, that is not a simple fix because most people are not absorbing the thyroid meds. Meaning your lab tests are normal because there's adequate hormones in the blood, but it's not getting anywhere. It's just hanging out in the bloodstream and not getting into the cell. And if that can't happen, then the cell, the organ, can't work best, like the liver. Make sense? So with that in mind, many people with Hashimoto's, in my experience, are dealing with a sluggish liver and a sluggish gallbladder. If you have low back pain, pain between your shoulder blades, itchy skin, maybe brain fog, maybe you can't handle fatty foods very well and it feels like a weight's in your gut, then you really want to pay attention here. In these situations, people aren't getting toxins and chemicals out of the body very well. If, for example, you have a sluggish gallbladder, cholestasis, or congestion anywhere in the bile ducts, it's very difficult to get toxins and chemicals out. If you have constipation, and I mean chronic constipation, you are also hoarding toxins and chemicals, and that's worsening not only the leaky gut, but your autoimmune disease as a whole. So this is why a thorough liver detoxification is a very, very great idea. I don't mean juice cleanses. I mean a scientifically proven way to support your liver and reduce inflammation. Even if you have a healthy functioning liver, you have healthy liver enzymes, AST and ALT are within the normal range, you don't have constipation, you can have all that, but you can still have issues with toxins and chemicals because you might be making an immune response against them. And yes, this holds true even if you have healthy toxic levels. One of the most misunderstood things about chemicals and toxins is the amount that causes problems for you is completely relative. Everyone has toxins, but to what degree do they cause autoimmune reactions in the body? That's the million-dollar question. So exposures can cause multiple symptoms, but often only after the burden bucket has overflowed, and that's completely relative to you. If your body can't meet the demand of burden and detoxify, you run into issues. The major sources of toxins and chemicals that I find in Hashimoto's would be from diet, GMO foods, particularly glyphosate, metals, pesticides, PCBs, titanium dioxide, mold, mycotoxins, medications even, and toxins that bacteria and fungus make called endotoxins, and even mental and emotional toxins like loneliness, anger, rage, isolation, and grief. Now, this might blow your mind. The research has shown that there can be low dose effects of toxins in people who have the right genes. So if you have a sluggish liver, you're not metabolizing very efficiently, that could be one of the reasons. One study showed that in a group of subjects where they studied 85 samples of chemicals, 59% of them exerted low dose effects. Okay, so that's what I mean. So what I'm saying is that you don't need to have a high abnormal toxin level in your blood to have a problem. You may have had metal testing done in the past or toxin testing, but it was all normal. But the question is, Is it really causing an immune problem, an immune dysregulatory problem? And is it worsening your Hashimoto's? It could be, but you're not going to see that on that type of test. You need to do other types of testing to see if there's an immune reaction against these chemicals and toxins. So that's the challenge with all this. And I know it's not your fault, but most doctors don't run these types of labs or even know this information exists. I will tell you a quick story of a Hashimoto's client I had about 2 years ago who is a great example of this, liver-gut connection. Her name was Erin, and she had been dealing with terrible constipation, gas, bloating, fatigue, hair loss, and couldn't handle many foods. She was on AIP, and it wasn't doing anything for her. She had done tons of supplements, changed her diet a dozen times, but it wasn't fixing anything. And so she just became exhausted from all of it after seeing tons of doctors. So when I started working with her, I began digging in to see what other underlying issues were being missed. A lot of people say to me that they've addressed everything and there's nothing left to explore. And I often find that there's still things being missed. And we found that for her as well. Turns out she had fatty liver. She had high liver enzymes. She was demonstrating brain fog, pain in her back, and having a hard time, real hard time digesting fat in her food. And so when you're dealing with fatty liver, there's oftentimes inflammation going on. And this is where you can run into serious issues related to high cholesterol, high LDL, high triglycerides. We discovered that her blood sugar issues, her toxin exposure, and her poor liver detoxification were the contributing factors to this problem. So we focused on all those things for about 8 weeks. And by the end of it, her enzymes came down, her gut improved, she had bowel movements again, and she had no more bloating or gas. Her skin actually cleared up as well, which was a bonus. That was the gateway to improving her leaky gut. But it couldn't have happened without accounting for her liver, because it's connected to the gut and removing toxins in her body. So, of course, reducing your exposure to toxins and chemicals has to be the biggest priority. But it's also very, very important to understand that the liver could always use more support, especially if you have Hashimoto's. In fact, I even support my liver detoxification all the time because we live in a world where there's tons of chemicals and toxins everywhere. We could always benefit from that support. There are two products that I love to use with my clients because it really just makes it easy to help metabolize these toxins and chemicals when you have a sluggish liver. So right here I have Antioxidant Power and Detox Support. So these are really great. I love this stuff. If you want to check it out, definitely click the link beneath this video and you can explore it and support liver detoxification if you feel like it. So in summary, here's your action steps. One, reduce your toxin load by looking at your diet, water supply, and in-home air quality. The air, the water, and the food are really the three biggest sources of chemicals and toxins that we face. Secondly, proper testing for body burden of chemicals and toxins is a great idea. Checking your AST and ALT liver enzymes would be a phenomenal idea as well if you have not done that. Thirdly, supporting your liver and gallbladder gently with supplements and nutraceuticals is a great thing I recommend. Again, I have detox support that I use with clients. I definitely recommend checking that out. And lastly, reducing inflammation, which will assist you in thyroid hormone absorption. That is what it all comes down to. So if you can do those things and get a grasp on what your level of burden is, you have a great chance in improving your gut health. In the Hashimoto's Academy, I do a deep dive into liver health, discussing how important it is in Hashimoto's. I go over a liver health assessment and go over the best effective and proven ways to support it so you can get the quickest results possible. So if you want to learn more about this aspect of Hashimoto's and more, feel free to check out the link below. And tomorrow we are going to go over the final topic, and I think it's one that you're definitely going to be interested in. Talk to you then.